JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 24th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained the most versus NOK, NZD, AUD and CHF in that order, while it lost some ground only against the Japanese yen. The strengthening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices closed unchanged or lower, with the only exception being Spain's IBEX 35, which gained 0.56%. Market sentiment deteriorated even further during the US and Asian sessions, with the main losers being Hong Kong's Hang Seng and Japan's Nikkei 225. European stocks eased yesterday amid fresh lockdowns across the continent. In Germany, Chancellor Angela Merkel decided to extend the existing restrictions until April 18th, while in France, new infections accelerated despite the start of a third lockdown. Austria postponed the reopening of cafes and restaurants. Later, in the US, sentiment was hurt further following the testimony of Fed Chair Jerome Powell and US Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen before the House Financial Services Committee. Yes, Powell reiterated his view that any spike in inflation in the months to come is likely to prove to be temporary, and Yellen repeated her optimism over the economic recovery. However, Yellen added that the US economy remains in crisis and defended developing plans for further tax increases in order to finance the new public investments. The two officials testified today before the Senate Banking Committee, but we don't expect to hear anything different. With all that in mind, fears of slower economic recovery in Europe and concerns over tax increases in the US may keep risk appetite subdued for longer than we have previously assumed. Equities, oil prices, and other risk-linked assets are likely to stay under selling interest for a while more, while the US dollar may continue to strengthen. That said, we still believe that this is a corrective phase. With most major central banks pledged to keep their respective monetary policies extra loose, and projecting that any inflation spikes in the months to come are likely to prove to be temporary, we do see the case for the prevailing uptrends in equities to resume in the foreseeable future. As for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK CPIs for February. The headline rate fell to 0.4% year over year from 0.7% instead of rising to 0.8% as the forecast suggested, while the core rate slid to 0.9% from 1.4% year over year, with the forecast being for an unchanged print. We also have the preliminary PMIs from several European nations, the Eurozone as a whole, the UK and the US. In Eurozone, the manufacturing index is forecast to have risen to 58.1 from 57.9, while the services one is expected to have inched up to 46 from 45.7. This is likely to take the composite index up to 49.1 from 48.8. Although an improvement, this still points to contraction, which combined with a chaotic vaccine rollout and the new lockdowns across the block is unlikely to result in enough optimism to boost European equities and the common currency. No forecasts are available for the UK prints, while in the US, both the manufacturing and services PMIs are anticipated to have risen to 59.4 and 60.2 from 58.6 and 59.8, respectively. In our view, US PMIs near the 60 mark will confirm that the economic recovery in the US continues at a fast pace, but the question is whether this will revive inflation fears. Apart from Powell and Yellen, we also have two more speakers on today's agenda, and those are New York Fed President John Williams and San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock a.m. GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.